All good? Hi, this is Eric Martin with Board Game Geek News. We're here looking at Abyss, forthcoming game, co-designed by Timo Motemaki and Kevin Wilson, and the designers whose name I forget, Thomas Klausner, coming from Dragon Dawn Productions. And right now we're looking at the cover of the game. I believe we're looking at the cover still at the moment. I'm not sure what the camera... Oh, hey! Hey, there you are. Good to see you. And we're here looking at a prototype of the game right now, which is coming out when? What's the expected release date?
We will be having a Kickstarter on April. Okay. Next year's April. And it will be with the Unbound Games, who is here this year with the Serpent's Tongue game. So.
So what's the nature of the game? What are we trying to
do? This is a dungeon crawl reinvented. Every other dungeon crawl that we have seen is based on dice. This is diceless. Okay. Every other dungeon crawl that we know is kind of like slower and having less of the Euro effects than what we have here. This is actually based on Rondel mechanic.
Okay. So. What?
Let me explain. This is like briefly explained that way, that you are playing a hero. Everyone plays one hero, and your hero in this case, in this example, is a rogue. You have 8 action points, out of which you need to divide your movement in the rondel on clockwise order and movement on the table. So this is a miniature game where the rondel mechanic has very central place. On your cards, each hero has a card deck which is unique, very, very different between the heroes. You can use these cards at any given point of time. For instance, number one plus responses are like this. So this would in total mean 2. So you could actually add that into your movement in here, into your movement in here, or to attack, or defense, or whatever action you like. So basically, these cards represent what in a normal, well, standard dungeon crawl would be a die.
But you get to control what you're playing when.
And these dice have been already rolled, and you know what did you get. So it's much better than having the die control you. You control the die this time. So let's assume that you would like to kill this guy in here. So first you would need to go to move to get close by. You don't have a line of sight right now, so you go to move. So that's 1 point, 2 points, leaves 6 points left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, for instance, like this. But in here, there is no line of sight, so we'll stay here. Okay. Your guy has range of 4, so basically you would be able to attack, except that you are now on move, so no, you just move.
Right.
Should you have been going already to charge, you would been able to first move and then attack. So this actually pretty much decides what kind of action do you do on the board as well. As these places in here are limited, that means that, for instance, if these guys are already in charge, I can't go to charge because it's full. That means that this is automatically controlling. When you have 6 players, you have also 6 of these, so its balance is automatically. You don't need to change anything between like player amounts. So this works between solo play to 6 players. We have 6 different heroes and more coming on the Kickstarter as stretch goals. This is based on scenarios that you can play. Of course, the scenarios are bigger than this, but this is just to explain the base game mechanics. So, if you would now be on the charge and would actually attack, you would take a look at what is his defense value. Let me take a look. It's here. So we have 6 different monster types. This is known as So this is known as the Acolyte. So his defense is 1, but it's 1 plus the response. The response has an average of 2, numbers between minus 1 to 5, but average is 2. So you know that basically it should have 3 in total, so it's 1 plus 2 in average. So now it's your time to think, like, how much would you like to invest on your dice So how much do you invest? Because your base attack value is 2 and you must get higher in order to make any damage. So let's assume that you would use this one and then the response. So that's 3 plus 2. So your attack is 5 and the monster gets to have 1. So it's 2. 5 against 2. You make a damage, and as this has only one hit point, it dies and goes to the dead monster's pile. So once all the heroes have done one action, it's time to see what the monsters do. Monsters do this way, they'll take one card, and today monsters do two actions. They first attack, and then they move. Should I have gotten, well, another 2, spawn and attack, one more, they would only move. So monsters are controlled by the response deck as well. So this is very multi-purpose deck that is used in this game. What else? Well, miniatures come unpainted, but some miniatures can be big and quite nice, I guess. And all of these miniatures comes with the game, so unpainted. So what we are seeing here is like a mixture between a Euro-style and American-style game on a dungeon crawl, which is having a very strong horror theme, and it's very quick to learn. My 7-year-old son can play this, so it can't be that complex.
Or you've got a genius 7-year-old. That should be the other, you know. Yeah.
Well, of course, he is like a gamer's son, so maybe there is some sort of house training, so to say. But basically, it's really not that complex to learn. The rule book is short, and so.
So, what are the variety of scenarios? Like, are there different time lengths or the different types of goals? What's in those?
Yeah, there are many different kinds of goals on those scenarios, and basically, there are also tactical options on how do you want to achieve the dungeon level. Basically, we have 7 levels on the base package at the moment. Maybe we will add some more on Kickstarter. But basically, each of those levels is between 45 minutes to 1.5 hours to play through. And it completely depends on what kind of combination of heroes you have, that how can you actually accomplish that. For instance, now we have only Rogue and a Mage. This is not very heavy-hitting team. So very probably we would try to evade the monsters on this duo. But then again, if we would have a couple of tanks like this, then you could just smash your way through the monsters and make mishmash out of the monsters.
So, of course, adding replayability, because you can just try again for whoever's going through
and,
there.
On the test game so far, we have found out that people are really appreciate the uniqueness of the heroes, so you really can't play a tank with this Magus, for instance. It's just not going to work. But then again, she has so powerful spells that can be very helpful on some specific occasions, so that you have to think that, okay, I have this character, how would I play?
And I see as well, of course, you've got the walk to death. If you, as you get injured, you can be eliminated from the game, and I guess everyone else carries on.
Yes. So we have several heroes. So if your hero dies on this level, on the next level, you can play another hero.
Anything else we should know about the game that you didn't mention?
Yeah, well, I think the basics are that it's having no die, no game master. Monsters are controlled by the simple mechanics, rondel-based, and having cool minis. I guess that's that.
All right. Thanks very much for the overview. Good luck
Thanks.
For the future.